Workers of the world, unite. That's the message in the Cloud Minders. We're going to meet two classes of humanoids. The Stratus dwellers, who are the ruling class, and the Troglodytes, who are the exploited workers. It's a perfect situation for Captain Kirk, who always sides with the underdog. To the series' credit, the leader of the revolution this time is a woman. A small step for womankind, and an added incentive for Kirk. In spite of all the short skirts and skimpy costumes, there actually were times when Star Trek treated the fair sex as the equal sex. Let's visit the Cloud Minders. Mr. Spock does some uncharacteristic things in the Cloud Minders. He divulges private Vulcan mating habits to a woman he's just met, when in a mock time, he could barely bring himself to talk about such matters with his best friend, Kirk. Many of the third season's episodes contain character inconsistencies. It would appear that many people in the decision-making positions, both at the network and with the series, seem to be suffering from burnout. After 3 years of 6 and 7 day work weeks, countless hours of overtime, and budget restraints, who could blame us? The Cloud Minders pays homage to the classic visionary science fiction film Metropolis, directed by Fritz Lang. The story involved two social classes, the thinkers and the workers, like the factions in the Cloud Minders. The groups in Metropolis cannot exist without each other. With innovative special effects and a strong social message, this 1926 silent film was re-released in 1984 with a new rock score. It's a classic well worth watching.